Hello everybody, welcome to the algorithm course. In this video, I'm going to discuss the interpolation search process. There are a number of steps to follow. First, we have to make sure that the array is already sorted and the elements are more or less uniformly distributed. Second, we have to make sure that the low index has to be smaller than or equal to the high index, and also that the target is really inside the portion of the array to be searched for. The meaning of the low index and the high index will be discussed later. Third, we have to evaluate the probable index of the target using the approach called linear interpolation. Four, we have to check if the element of the probable index is really equal to the target. If the element is on the left-hand side of the array, we have to just handle the left-hand side and update the high index accordingly. On the other hand, if the element is on the right-hand side of the array, we just handle the right-hand side and then we update the low index accordingly. And then we just continue steps 2 to 6 until the target equals the element of the probable index, which means that the element can be found from the array, or until the low index is higher than the high index, or the target is really outside the portion of the array to be searched for. In these cases, we say that the target cannot be found from the array using the interpolation search process. Before we talk about the search process, we have to understand the word called uniformly distributed numbers. Interpolation search works better when the elements are uniformly distributed. So we can see these numbers on the slide, and you can see that the difference between two successive numbers is the same, which is 3 in my case. If you have such an array of uniformly distributed numbers, then interpolation process would work pretty well. In order for the interpolation search process to work, the difference between the successive numbers should be around the same. We don't have to fix the difference between two successive numbers, but as long as the differences between any two successive numbers are pretty much the same, we are already able to use the interpolation search process to find out the target. And then we have to talk about the meaning of interpolation in this search process. Suppose we have 4 data points, and when we plot the index together with the value, we can see that these 4 points tend to lie on a certain straight line. This happens when the successive data have similar differences, so that they can lie on a certain straight line with slope m and y-intercept called c. If we have this kind of data, we can use linear interpolation to find out the slope m and the y-intercept c of a certain straight line. Now, let us see the real process of the interpolation search process. First, we let the highest index of the array a be h and the lowest index be l. And then, if the leftmost and the rightmost data points lie on the fitting line, we can set up two equations, shown in equation 1 and equation 2. These two equations demonstrate the relationship between the index L or H, the element value corresponding to those indices called A of L or A of H. And we are also able to join these two equations by using the same slope m and y-intercept c. Also, if the data to be searched for is called d and its corresponding index is called I, we can set up equation 3, d equals mi plus c. So I just put d and I into the straight line because I'm already sure that the data point to be searched for should lie on that particular line. From equations 1 and 2, after manipulation, we are able to find out the value of m in terms of the high and low indices and the corresponding values of these two indices. And then from equations 1 and 3, we can have some manipulation to find out the value of I in terms of the low index, the slope, the element of the low index, together with the data to be searched for called d. And then I can put m into the previous equations so that I can have the expression of I, which means the probable index position according to the low index, high index, and their corresponding values together with the value of D. Here D means the value to be searched for. Then let us see how we can make use of the value of I obtained from the indices and the index values. First, we can determine the value of I by using the previous formula. If I is not an integer, we can take the floor of it, so that I just take the integer part of that particular value. Number two, if the left part is to be retained, I just keep the value of L unchanged, and then I change the value of H, which is equal to I minus 1, so that I want to choose the left-hand part. And number three, if the right part is to be retained, I just update the low index to I plus 1, and then I keep the value of H unchanged. Number four, if I find that the index element is really equal to the target, then I just say that the target is found. On the other hand, if the index value corresponds to an element that is on the left-hand side of the low index element, then I just say that the target cannot be found because A of I cannot be in the portion of the array to be searched for. Also, if the value of index I is on the right-hand side of the high index element, I also say that the target cannot be found. Now, let us see an example. Suppose I want to search for number 34 from these sorted numbers. First, I have to check that the numbers are more or less uniformly distributed. And when I see the differences between any two successive numbers, I can see that the numbers are more or less between 3 and 5. And I'm pretty sure that the elements are more or less uniformly distributed, then I can be confident to use the interpolation search process. First, I let the leftmost index be L, which is 0 here, and I also let the index of the rightmost element be H, which is number 8 here. And now I'm able to see that because L is smaller than or equal to H, I'm able to find out the corresponding value of I, which means the probable position of the target in my given array. Now I'm able to see that I is equal to 6.86. Since it is a decimal number, I just take the floor of it to get 6. So the probable index is 6. And I see that AI, which is equal to A6 here, is 29. But the target is 34. So I'm sure that the target is larger than A of 6. That means we don't choose the left-hand side. Instead, I choose the right-hand side. In this case, I have to update the low index to I plus 1. So now the low index becomes 7. Now, since low is still smaller than or equal to high index, I'm still able to find out the corresponding value of I, which is 7. But now 7 is already an integer. That means I just take this value as it is. So now we see that I becomes 7, L is also 7, and H is still 8. And A of I is 34. That means the target element is equal to A of I. So in this case, we say that the target is found at index 7, which is represented by letter I. And we say that the search is done. On the other hand, let us see another example. Suppose I want to find out 15 from the given array. And I already checked that the numbers are quite uniformly distributed because the differences between any two successive numbers are pretty much the same between 3 and 5. Again, I still let the leftmost index be L, which is 0 now, and the index of the rightmost element is H, which is now 8. Now I can find out the value of I, which means the probable index of the target. Now I can see that since L is smaller than or equal to H, I can still find out the value of I. I is now 2.51. And I just take the floor of it because I is actually a decimal number. But for an index to be valid, it cannot be a decimal number. That's why I have to have some means to turn it to an integer. Now we see that A of I is now 13, which corresponds to index 2. But we see that the target, which is 15, is still larger than A of I. Then it means that we have to select the right-hand part. In order to select the right-hand part, I have to update the value of L to I plus 1. So now I becomes 3. Now, since L is still smaller than or equal to H, we can see that the value of I can be found as usual by using the formula. And now we see that I is equal to 2.78. Since it is not an integer, I can take the floor of it to make it an integer. So the value of I is still 2. But we have to say something here. Since the value of A of I is actually smaller than the value of A of L, it means that the target is not able to be located in the portion of the array to be searched for. That means the target cannot exist in the remaining portion of the array. And we can just say that the target cannot be found from the given array. Thank you for walking through the algorithm with me. If you have any questions about my video, please leave your comments at the comment section below the video. If you like this video, please give me a like and please subscribe to my channel. Thank you for watching.